Now, the last legislative session at the old State House was in 1909, when this was Arkansas's state capitol. After that, they moved to the new state capitol, which is on the grounds of the old Arkansas State Penitentiary. That's where the state capitol stands today. The Arkansas legislature came back to the old State House in 1951 to dedicate this place as a museum. And then they met once more in 1983 for one day of business. Thanks to the archives of the Pryor Center for Oral and Visual History and KATV News, we were there.
The General Assembly had not met in the old State House for 74 years. In fact, it was the first time some of the lawmakers had even been inside the historic old building in downtown Little Rock. Where the lawmakers of today laughed and joked, the lawmakers of yesterday considered things such as secession from the Union. It was strictly a ceremonial day at the old State House, but the speaker reminded members of the past.
But I wonder if our problems now are any less pressing. They probably aren't. Because as we gather here today, we recall the significance of those early meetings and their historical importance in the shaping and the development of our state.
Later, the governor arrived to address a joint session. He said the state must continue its commitment to restoring and repairing the building. He also repeated the words of the man who first wanted the State House built.
John Pope, third territorial governor of Arkansas, described it as a state house built with taste and elegance near the fine river which passes by this town. It will command the admiration and respect of the passing stranger and have a moral and political influence on the entire community. In that sense, this state house is a symbol. It was then and it is now, of our belief in our state's growth and progress, and of our ability to bring out the best in ourselves and our resources.
As impressed with the old state house as most legislators seem to be, the General Assembly will probably not wait another 74 years to meet here. Randy Weber, News Scene 7.